Hi, everybody. It's Dr. Lori, the PhD antiques appraiser. This is Ask Dr. Lori Live. Everything's unscripted. My guests are here with their stuff. I'm going to show you what to look for, how to spot those valuables so you can resell for top dollar and build your own great collections. Guests from all over. I want to hear where you're watching from, where you're calling from, and let's get started. Hold those up those objects. Let's see what you've got. Hold them up to the camera so I can see them. All right. Let's start with this blue ring.
Hi, Dr. Lori.
Hi, how are you? Your camera has to be horizontal.
It won't go that way. It flips.
Well, that's because it's locked. So we got to find somebody else who doesn't have a locked camera.
Uh-oh.
I'm not going to watch snow. I'm not going to make you watch things that are uncomfortable. Bad connections aren't going to work either. It's got to be that.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, you got it right. Let's go back to that ring.
Oh, all right.
Yeah, a little school marm goes a long way, huh?
My granddaughter did it. I don't know how.
Back up, honey.
But back up.
Back up. Yeah.
Yeah.
There you go. Focusing. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Roxanne. I'm calling from Wyoming, Michigan.
All right. So how'd you acquire this piece that looks like a star sapphire? Is it marked?
All it has in it is numbers and letters.
Okay.
A bunch of them.
So it's a paste piece. Okay. Where'd you acquire it?
Secondhand store. I don't know.
So it's trying to look like something that it's not. It's trying to look like something that it's not. So it's trying to look like a star sapphire. It's nice. It's a cabochon, but it's probably actually made of a composite material set in a silver toned metal. I would say value on it, probably $35.
Oh, okay. That's why that line is everywhere in it too.
That's right.
Yeah.
Hey, what to look for? Here's the things that you want to look for. You want to look for a cabochon, right? So it's carved, right? So it looks like that half moon or that half sphere, right? You want that.
Okay.
So that you have. You want to make sure that when you're looking at it, that you can not see anything like bubbles. You can't see anything that looks like something has been melted down and then molded. Okay. That's what you have there. You can also oftentimes see sort of a line all the way around it, not quite a seam, but where actually the mold ends, that's probably covered up by the setting. So you've got to look underneath the ring for that. My question of the day is about the question of the day. I get a lot of comments all over social media and of course here on the channel where people go, I don't like the question of the day. I do like the question of the day. What are you doing about the question of the day?
I do.
You like it? Why do you like it?
I don't know. It's just interesting to see what everybody says.
I think it's interesting too. But again, I don't want to impose my opinions on you. Well, actually, I do want to impose my opinions on you because my opinions are going to teach you stuff. Anyway,
yeah.
I wanted to know about the question of the day. Thanks so much. Good to see you.
Thank you. You too.
Thank you also for the super chats and super stickers. It helps to support the channel. What does that mean? I'm trying to give you a video every single day, right? If you share the channel, if you watch the channel, if you support the channel, I'm going to be able to do that. So thank you very much for the super chats and super stickers. If you've made money because you've been watching the channel, I think a super chat and a super sticker at any amount would be appropriate. All right, let's see what we've got. Hold up those objects. I need them in front of the camera so I can see them. All right, let's see what we've got. Let's see what this piece of jewelry looks like, this necklace.
Hi, Dr. Lori. This is Ina from Fort Wayne.
Hi, Ina. What have you got there, kiddo?
So this is a Coro dragon's breath necklace.
Okay, so since you use the term dragon's breath, you want to explain why they call it a dragon's breath?
I will let you do that because I'm not sure.
Of course you will. Why did you use that term if you don't know what that term means?
Because I was looking around for that color stone. That's the closest thing I saw.
Okay. So you looked around on eBay or Etsy or with other listings and you took somebody's information and you just said that's going to be accurate.
Well, I kind of look on like jewelry research sites.
Okay, so I don't care where you look, but if you don't know that information is accurate, you're taking a risk, right? So you're saying, well, it was on that site. I'm hoping this person is right, but you don't know if they're right.
Yeah, that's why I haven't posted it yet.
You have to back up your research. You have to back up what you say. It's like supporting evidence when you're writing a paper. You remember that in high school? You couldn't stand that nonsense. You have to support what you say. You do, because somebody's going to say to you, what is it? Right. So just so you have an understanding of that. It's marked Coro on the clasp, correct?
On the J clasp. Yep.
Okay. It's marked on the J clasp. That's good. And that's an important thing. That's a what to look for. For example, when you're looking at these pieces, certain Coro pieces will be marked on the setting, certain Coro pieces, Coro, the costume jewelry designers, of course, of the 1950s, 60s and such, are maybe marked only on the clasp. So you have to look for where the mark is, setting or clasp. It's going to matter, and it's going to help you with respect to dating the piece. And that's important too. So that's cool. So anyway, this particular piece, how did you acquire it?
I think it was in a blue box, if I'm not mistaken.
Okay, so a blue box, $30, $40, right?
$39.99 for five.
Yeah, sometimes they're $34, sometimes they're $39, but they've gone to about $39.99. The Goodwill blue boxes, they take place, you know, at Goodwill, basically, you know, at 6 p.m. on a Friday night. You get them, and you better be ready.
You better be ready.
They go like that. And then you got all kinds of jewelry in it. And so you went through it, you pieced through it, right? Russell's through it, treasure hunting, right? And you found this piece. Value on that piece, $95.
Okay.
Very good. Very good.
Thank you. Based on
actual sales records where similar pieces have sold, that's another thing you have to look for. When you're looking through listings, you have to make sure that you know where they've sold, right? So you're saying, well,
yeah, I go to the sold always.
Okay. So make sure that you know that they've sold not only at one place, you know, not only at one place, not only on one site, but many sites.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So you're not looking only in one particular area. I like that a lot. Good for you.
Thank you.
My question of the day is, do you like the question of the day or not?
Yes.
What do you like about it?
It's random. I never know what you're going to ask.
Right. Great. Nice to see you. Thank you very much.
Thanks,
for the super
chats
and super stickers. And thank you for being my guest from Fort Wayne, Indiana, which is a fun, fun place to go. So lots of things to show you, lots of things to teach you. And of course, I want you to succeed. So you can help me succeed, and you can help yourself succeed. Video calls. That's right. Booking a video call, all different types. You can even do gift certificates with video calls if you want to give yourself a gift or give somebody else a gift. Video calls will provide you with information and a one-on-one with me to ask whatever questions. You don't want to do this, for example. You're saying, I don't want to be in front of everybody. I just want to talk to Dr. Lori. You can do that too. Yeah, I think the question of the day is fun, but a lot of people have been very vocal that they don't think it's fun. They're entitled to their opinion too. Thanks for the video chat. Oh, I missed it. Okay, anyway. So is it dragon's breath or not? No, it is not dragon's breath, as a matter of fact, Pat. That particular piece was not dragon's breath, and that's why I want her to be careful, and all of you to be careful about what information you are taking from the internet and thinking that it is accurate. That's why I want you to be careful. So a lot of these terms actually come up based on color, that kind of thing. So that's what we see. The question of the day is not the only thing that puts excitement in this show, buddy. Let me tell you. The excitement in this show is my guests and the appraisals and the information and what to look for and me. So thanks for being with me. And thanks for your comment too. My guests are here. I'm going to look at their art, antiques, and collectibles. I'm going to show you what to look for. Okay. Let's go with the framed piece. The person has blue walls behind her or him. I can't see because they're hiding. And it's a landscapes with some trees.
Cool.
Hi, what's your name? Hi. Where are you calling from?
I'm Justin, calling from near Albany, New York.
Hi, Justin. Can you hold that up and back up for me?
Yeah, I was thinking I should do that.
Okay. Justin, I'm not crazy about this. How'd you acquire this kind of little hut?
It's really interesting. I got it in Western Mass, and there were three of them, but I just chose this one to show you.
Like Northampton, like that neck of the woods?
More near the Berkshires.
Okay. The reason I ask is, depending on where these places are, where you find these places, it sometimes is important for you to understand what's happening in that place. So the Berkshires, of course, as many folks who come to the Berkshires for all different, for vacation. In the summer, it's a very lively place, of course. In the winter, it is as well for the ski bunnies. So that's why I always ask, well, where did you get it? And was it a thrift store, a yard sale, a estate sale?
It was a thrift store. Everything was half off.
And so you purchased three of them?
Yeah, it was from the same artist, and I got them for $30 collectively.
Okay, so $10 a piece. You can't go wrong at $10 a piece, Justin, right? Can I see the back?
Yep.
And then I'll tell you what I don't like about it and what you should look for. Okay, a couple things. Look at the size of the stretcher bars. Look how thin they are. They're probably only about 2 inches. Typically, stretcher bars that date pre-1960 are about 2 inches or smaller. Bigger ones typically happen in the later part of the 20th century if you have a piece from the 20th century. Is the piece signed? So look for the size of the stretcher bars, not the frame, the stretcher bars. He has his hands on the stretcher bars right now. All right, let's see the other side. So I'm looking at a 1960s, 1970s, 1980s piece. And is it signed?
It is signed.
Yeah, this is touristy to me. This is touristy, the Caribbean, that kind of thing. So you paid $10 for it. How big is it?
I think it's 14 by 19.
Is that with the frame?
Yeah.
Okay, 14 by 19, you're probably looking at about $85 for this piece. For your $10 investment, you get 8 times more. So that's a pretty good investment.
Awesome.
Awesome is right. And the other two are probably, if they're the same size, same artist, same composition, same subject matter, about the same, possibly. Condition is always important. My question of the day is about the question of the day. Like it or hate it?
I don't mind it. I like it because it reminds me of when I bartended and we would have tip wars of like Brad versus Angelina Jolie kind of thing. So,
oh, cool. Yeah, I bet bartending is a lot of fun. You like know everything and hear everything, right?
Exactly.
Cool. Nice to see you. Congratulations. Nice to see
you. Thank you.
You're welcome. I didn't like that painting because I don't like the fact that the figures are sort of an afterthought. It's just we're going to focus on one part of the painting, or the landscape, and then the figures are not all that important to the artist. They just kind of do it as an afterthought. I don't like that. If you're going to focus on something, do the whole thing right or leave the figures out. So that's basically where we are in looking at all of that. Do you post anything from the classes that you put on like last night? I missed so much. Well, you have to pay attention in class. What can I tell you? So no, the classes are, of course, you can attend my classes. You're welcome to, of course, join the classes. And all of that is on my events page at drlorieV.com. It's easy to find at drlorieV.com. And of course, you'll see all of the things that I'm doing right there on the website. And you can also check out the specials and shop page if you want to, again, buy merchandise, for example, or maybe you want to support the channel in one way or another. Maybe you need a loop or maybe you need a gem tester. So you can do that at drlorieV.com as well in the specials and shop page. I do get compensation when, of course, you purchase something, but hopefully you will support the channel too. But no, the classes are for the students in the class. So become a student. It's easy for you to do that. Just like Roan Rivers, you're not afraid to speak your mind. I love that. Thank you very much, Lisa. I'm not afraid anymore to speak my mind. There are many, many people who say terrible things about my mind, but there are a lot of people who know that me sharing my mind is going to help a lot of people. So yeah, no, I'm not afraid to speak my mind. And I think everybody should have the chance to speak their mind too. It's not only my opinion, it's about everybody's opinion. I think people don't always see that in me. I think they all think, oh, she just thinks she's bold and right and that's it. And that's really not who I am. So that's great. Anyway, you'd love to know about the art piece over my right shoulder. Okay, now I got to figure out which is my right shoulder. If this is the art piece you want to know about, this is a Pennsylvania artist named Glenn Heron. And that is a typical Pennsylvania impressionist piece in that tradition, although he's an artist who's still working today. And this piece is a piece by the Pratt Institute instructor artist Gene Wilkinson, who is very well known as one of the American abstract artists of the American Abstract Art Society. She is extremely well-versed. She had many exhibitions, publications. She's a hot shot. So that piece is one of her works based on sort of the works of stain painting like Helen Frankenthaler. So there you go. I'm sorry I don't know which is right or left because I'm looking a different way than you are. Actually, I never really learned right and left. It's kind of hard for me still. Oh, but that's not what we're talking about tonight. Hi, everybody. How are we doing? What have we got? Let's see what we've got. Okay. Let's see what we have here she has a green piece behind her. She has something green behind her. And it looks like it's a necklace. What's your name? Yeah. Where are you calling from, hon?
My name's Leanne. I'm calling from Illinois.
Okay. What do you have here, Leanne?
I got this in some Goodwill jewelry about 3 years ago. And it's like sterling silver, and I'm pretty sure it's lapis and coral.
Can you get close?
Yep.
So you've got the lapis would be what to look for. The lapis would be the very sort of the darker of the blues. And then it looks like it also has coral, which of course is that coral or orangish color, orange gold. It also looks like it's set in sterling silver. Is it marked sterling or 925?
Not that I could find.
Okay. And then if you turn it back over the way you had it, as opposed to changing it, because you're moving everything and I'm trying to teach people stuff. I tell you, you guys. All right. And if you'll notice, then those teardrop shapes look like actual turquoise. Notice the multi-strands that are holding on these other pieces in a type that's like, but not, it is not, but it is like a squash blossom, where you've got multi-strands that are holding other elements. Oftentimes you're going to see those types of pieces. So it's not marked at all, not even with a maker or designer's mark or a pictogram?
No, no.
No, okay, all right. So do you remember what you paid?
Probably about 50 cents.
Oh, because it was in a whole big group.
Right, right, yeah.
So let's say it's not sterling. Let's say it's 800 parts per thousand, right? Let's like go the low level, right? Then okay. We'll talk about if it's sterling. If it's the low level and it's 800 parts per thousand silver, right? You're probably, or 80% silver, 80% pure, right? Then you're looking at a piece that's probably worth in the 100 to maybe 120 value range. It dates to about the 1970s into the late 1970s, right? If you have it in its sterling silver, you're going to bump it up around $175, maybe even $200. And I do think, based on the forms, that you're probably looking at the Plains States Native Americans. Okay. Not Southwestern, not New Mexico, not Arizona, not the Navajo, not down there. I want to get you in the middle, like the Lakota Sioux and those people, South Dakota, that neck of the woods.
Right? Awesome.
Nice. Right. Good for you. Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you.
My pleasure. It's always my pleasure. Question of the day, like it or hate it.
Like it or hate what?
My question of the day. I always ask the question of the day. What do you like? Do you like it or do you think, we don't need it?
I like it.
I like it. And I like your pink hair too. So there you go.
Oh, thanks.
Nice to see
have
you.
Have a good one.
No, you too. So a couple of things, what to look for. So if you have multiple, right, if you have multiple stones like those, you want to make sure that you see that consistent pattern. Oftentimes in Native American pieces, particularly jewelry of the mid to late 20th century, mid to late, of course, 1900s, you're going to see those consistent patterns and things that repeat, elements that repeat, and then they're just put on, of course, multi-strand necklaces, that kind of thing. That's what we're seeing for the most part. Your son is starting to develop an interest because you're sharing my videos. You need to share my videos. You need to share them more. My husband is really into you, and he's a big fan of Oak Island. That's right. That's right. Anyway, so that's great. I don't know who Isabella is who won't watch me, but, you know, maybe Isabella can be turned around too. But that's anyway good. So, the asparagus canister. Actually, there were some TV hosts this week. I was appearing, of course, on my regular TV hits, and they asked about the asparagus canister too. Part of a canister set. And I want to hear your opinions on the question of the day and where are you calling or watching from? And the canister set is one of a canister set. It's all vegetables. And I was telling the host that, you know, a lot of people like, of course, the idea of vegetables as canister sets prior to getting sort of the typical canister set. So vegetables and fruits. Fruits are much more popular, but vegetables in the 1980s became popular too for those sets. So that's what it is. It's a 1980s era asparagus canister. So, hi, how are you? Everything good? I got to see these objects. All right. I want to go with the lamp. A couple of things about the lamp right off the bat. I'm sorry, I'm going to go fast, then I'm going to come back and ask you the specifics, like who are you and where are you? So Sure. Bear with me. Couple things. First of all, when you are looking at Scandinavian design or mid-century modern design, it is the contrast of materials that is what makes it great. So you've got glass against wood, or you have metal against wood, or you have glass against metal. What to look for is that contrast of materials. The other thing about it is the wood is not all shined up and lacquered to heck. It's basically wood for wood's sake. So it the natural form, you know, if it's a funny, you know, if it's a funny knot in the wood, they leave it and they embrace what's natural. Hi, I'm Dr. Lori. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
I'm Charity, calling from Columbus, Ohio.
Hi, Charity. How are you doing?
Doing pretty good. How
are
you? Nice
to see you.
You too.
Thanks for being with me. How'd you acquire this?
I got this at an online auction.
Okay. How much did you pay?
Probably more than I should have. I think it was closer to $60.
Okay. Does it work?
It does.
Okay. Can you show me the plug?
Mm-hmm.
Because in addition to knowing the contrast, I want you to see a couple things. That plug right there is a 1955 to 1970 plug. It probably dates between 1955 and 1962. How do you know that, Dr. Lori? If Charity will pick up the plug again and let everybody take a second look. First of all, you don't have that third prong, and on most, you don't have the third prong. The other thing is you have basically the head of the plug, right? The wire of the plug goes in the side, not in, like if the plug is like this, it doesn't go here in the middle. It goes in one side or the other side, okay? That's another point of a mid-century plug. And the plugs are going to help you to identify, right? If you had a round plug, you're probably looking at the 1930s or 40s, okay? And these are going to help you identify. And you're going to go, well, they could rewire it. Yeah, they could rewire it, but in this case, they didn't rewire it. Are there any labels left on the piece?
There are no labels, and there are a few things I wanted to kind of point out because I'm curious.
Okay.
One, this has crackle glass.
Okay.
But the thing that I was curious about is there are a couple hole marks on two sides that almost make me wonder, like, if it was...
There are pieces there that went this way.
Yeah.
There are pieces that went this way around.
Yeah.
So you're missing those, although I have to say it doesn't really bother me, but
okay.
I mean, I think it might bother others. But yes, there were those. There were those. That's true. Something else was there that you don't have anymore. I have to say the fact that those are not terribly violating the piece, you know, it's not scratched or pulled off or something's left there and stuck in.
Right.
You know, I don't think that that's bad. I also think that the fact that you do have that modernist geometric sort of round against very geometric or straight is still kind of nice. The crackle glass, in fact, does work, but it's not very common. Usually you won't see crackle glass like that on a piece of this time period. I don't think it's a marriage. I think it's a rarity.
Yeah.
Do you guys all know what a marriage is? A marriage is when two dissimilar things come together and stick it out no matter what. A marriage. Two objects come together for some reason. This particular piece, I think it is actually a rarity. They were trying something as opposed to a marriage, but they did take something off. They were straight, actual, same pieces of wood, but they were straight.
Yeah.
So you paid 60. Is that what you said?
I think it was close to 60, I think.
Value on it's probably 225.
Okay.
So you did okay at 60, you know?
So when I saw it, I thought it was like along the lines of Danish or something like that. It's not, right? Or is it?
No, I think the piece is Swedish. It's Scandinavian, but it's not Danish.
Okay.
I think it's Swedish, probably not Danish. You know, it's not, you know, it's not one of the Jurgensons. It's not that, but it's a nice piece either way. I like that it actually is in working condition. And I like the fact that you have the original wiring too.
Yeah. Cool. Thanks. Hey, Mike,
thanks so much. Nice to see you from Columbus. And tell me the question of the day, take it or leave it?
Take it?
I guess. Jerry's like, what do I care? Whatever. Nice to see you.
Thanks, you too. Uh-huh.
So when you're looking at pieces like this on online auctions and you're not sure, now maybe with the photograph of the online auction, she wasn't able to see those little holes, right? So what I want you to make sure that you do is if you have questions when you are looking at online auctions, get in touch with the auction, right? And say, hey, I'd like some more photos. Can you give me a close-up photo? And one of the best places to add, one of the best areas to ask for of a close-up photo is the underside of the piece. Because while if there is not a mark, there might be residue from a label, and that might help you too. Also, if you think you see something in a photograph, ask them to zoom in and take another photograph. A lot of times they will, and a lot of times they won't. If they don't help you, think about another auction. You know, don't spend your money in places where they're not going to try to help you. Subscribe to the newsletter. Tips like the one I just gave you are in the newsletter. It's free. All you have to do is go to drlorivee.com where there's a thumbs up free icon. It's a thumbs up. And all you have to do is go there, click on that free icon. You'll put in your email address. And when we send out the email, which is regular with the newsletter in it, you'll get that email. And it's great. Thank you very much for your super chats and super stickers. It helps support the channel. And for those of you who are saying, oh, you know, I wish you wouldn't thank everybody, I'm thanking everybody because it supports the channel. These people are helping you because I'm going to make more videos because they're supporting. So, and you can support in many different ways. So I appreciate all that you're doing. And I appreciate when you share. I love you too, Fern. Fern from Massachusetts. I got a child's chair from what I believe the late 1800s. Just a soft cloth to clean it. Well, what is the child's chair? Is it upholstery? Is it wood? Is it carved? Is it, and what is it? I mean, you got to give me a little bit more than that. You can always send a picture to me, right? excuse me. You can always send a picture to me, of course, and I'll take a look at it. QOTD must be question of the day, right? Okay. I'm terrible with those things, though. Those acronym things, those letters, I'm terrible at that. I know like LOL, and that's about the extent of it. When I'm talking to friends of mine who are younger, they're doing all of this, and I'm texting, I'm going, I don't know what that means. Excuse me. Oh, goodness. I guess I'll take the print. The print that looks like it's a seascape.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
I'm so good. How are you, Dr. Lori?
I'm fine, darling. What's your first name? Where are you calling from?
My name's Kendall. I'm calling from Washington, D.C.
Hi, Kendall. It's nice to see you. Hey, Kendall, can I ask you a personal question? You don't have to answer it if you don't want to. It's not that personal, really. I'm seeing that all of these people are wearing very, very long hair. This is in now. Is that the deal?
You know, I guess. I don't know. I think
you... Did you always wear long hair?
You know, I've always had long hair, but what my like moment of diversion from my childhood would be getting kind of like the 70s bangs, which I think is very on trend right now.
Okay. Well, I would think you would know. You look like the type of person who would know. All right.
Well, so, thank you.
Honey. Sorry. Do the bangs drive you nuts? The bangs drive me nuts. I can't stand
I have them cut long enough so that they go behind my ear because I had these for a while and that was just I couldn't deal with it.
All right. Well, nice to see you, honey. Thank you for giving me a couple salon tips. So tell me, how did you acquire this piece?
I found this in a Goodwill outside of DC. It is, I believe, a print by Albert Flocon.
Yep.
And it says on the bottom, it says in French, essay, meaning attempt. And then it says Chateau en Espagne, meaning castles in Spain.
Yep. Good.
Sorry.
Keep going. You were saying, go ahead.
I looked him up and apparently he released like a Chateau en Espagne collection in 1957, but this is dated 1953. So
a portfolio. A portfolio. So let's explain a couple of different things. What you have is a lithographic print. That means it is carved into a stone, inked, greased, and then pressed into paper. They pencil sign it as well as sign in the plate, right? And in this particular case, what you have there, and you can see that it's dated and all, I like the fact that what you have is probably the first thoughts of the artist's work before he does the big series, the portfolio series. So that's going to be worth more than one that you get from 1958 of the same subject matter.
Sure.
Okay. So looking up that information is great. How much did you pay?
$5.99.
And remind me, where did you get it? Like a Goodwill or a thrift store?
I got it at a Goodwill outside of DC.
Okay. So a couple of other things. Remember, the major cities and the more elite neighborhoods, like Georgetown, for example, the Goodwill in Georgetown is probably going to have better stuff than the Goodwill in a place
that
isn't
as well.
I'm sorry. I'm sure they don't.
Good for them.
I'm using that as an example, Kendall.
Yeah.
But you're right about that. So value on that piece is going to be about $250, which is high for a print like that. That portfolio of his work typically would bring somewhere around $175 for each one unframed. I'd add another $75 for the frame because you have a nice matting and nice frame on it. And you paid $5.99.
Exactly. And the frame, it's not like a period frame, but I noticed that it was from Framebridge, which is an expensive framing service. And so I was like, someone paid money to get this framed. So I looked at it and then I got it.
That's right. You got it, kid. You got it. You got the long hair. You got the right print. You're doing great.
Thanks,
do you like the question of the day or not?
Yeah, I do like it. I think it adds a personal element and just shows that you care about us, which I appreciate. But yeah, I think it's important that we ask you too, because you talk to us all day long. And I just appreciate that you take your time and share your knowledge. And yeah, thank you so much for everything.
You're sweet, honey. Thank you. Nice to see you. Keep it up. I do like to know what you're doing. That's why we do the question of the day. But again, those of you who don't like it or want me to do something else, I want to hear that too. And of course, I want to know where you're calling from. And hey, if you want to suggest a question of the day, have at it. I'll look at those too. Don't forget about the binge link. Why? Because you know what? A lot of you are missing a lot of the videos. Dr. Lori, you never talk about jewelry. Yes, I do. You're missing the binge link. Dr. Lori, you never talk about ceramics. Yes, I do. It's on the binge link. Where can you find the binge link? At drlorivee.com at the specials and shop page, which is the red button at the top of the page. Scroll down that page, go to that big red binge link button, and it's going to give you a link. Save the link and look at it. It's going to give you all of the videos I do, because just like, for example, videos that, you know, you're saying, I didn't know that she was on, you know, the History Channel, or she was on with Bobby Bones, or she was on with, you know, television networks, or she was on here, or she was on there. All of those are going to be on the binge link, and they may not be, of course, here. So I want you to use that binge link so you can get all the information that I do. Anyway, good to see you, and I love my guests. It's great to see all of them. Let's see. We've got guests galore from all over. Let's see what they've got. All right. Well, let's go with this piece of glass. Looks like a glass kind of tree.
Hello, Dr. Lori. How are you this evening? Yeah, it is.
I'm fine. How are you?
Good, good.
What's your name?
My name's Michael. I'm actually from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania this evening.
Hey, Michael, can you turn off that big bright light?
Absolutely.
I know you're trying to help, but let's start with what you got. Back up a little bit for me, hon.
Absolutely, not a problem.
All right, and tell me where you got this piece and what you think about it.
This was from a secondhand store right outside of Philadelphia. $10. I wound up paying only $10 for it.
Hold it up a little bit more.
Absolutely.
And who's there talking with you?
That is a very good friend of mine, Miss April.
Okay. So you got this piece. Is it marked on the bottom?
No, it's not.
What do you think it is? I know you think it's something.
My suggestion, my thought is it is Murano.
Okay.
But that
why?
Because we found it online.
I found a green one. We found as
why
a
don't you just let? Why doesn't she just talk? Why don't you get on the camera and talk?
I know.
I'll just come over here.
Here you go.
Come over there. Hi, hon. How are you?
Fine. Good. How are you?
Well, I didn't mean to make Michael run away. I'm just saying he can stay too.
Come sit down too.
Oh gosh, now they're doing musical chairs. What did I start? All right.
Michael found this. You know, $10 at Liberty Thrift. He's always going to the thrift stores. Yeah. Found this. Brought
this person can get in too. Who's that?
What's that?
Who's this other person? There's somebody else there too. Why are we hiding?
This is Dr. Connor.
I'm a cat. Yeah, I'm a cat veterinarian.
He just got off work.
Hi, it's nice to see you.
I love this piece.
Thank you for taking care of the animals.
Yeah,
we need you.
He treats cats. Yes.
It's very Yuletide.
For the cat. It is Yuletide. Here's why it looks like it is Murano. That swirl. What to look for. The gold flex.
Yes, the gold flex.
Right? The gold flex, right? Uh-huh. And of course, that nice bulb, at the bottom that has a nice straight, it's a foot. You know, when you're watching Rachel Ray, and Rachel Ray says when she's going to cut something, she tells you to make a foot so you don't cut your hand off.
Yeah.
That's the same thing they're doing in the glass factory so they don't burn the whole thing. Right. Got it? Okay. He paid
$10? $10 at Liberty Thrift right by our house.
It's worth $150 anytime. Nice. At holiday time, it's worth
$175. Nice.
Very nice. Where's Michael? I want to see a smile from Michael. Are you happy?
Thank you very much for your time, Dr. Lori.
My pleasure. I'm happy to do it. Thanks for all getting into the shot.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank
you. Hey, my question of the day, do you like it or hate it?
I've been watching you like crazy. Binge
watching. Well, keep watching.
Absolutely.
I'm a psychiatrist, and I've been watching this at night to relax from work.
Well, I think that's great. I love that I'm relaxing the psychiatrist. That's great. Because you must need relaxation, because we're all a little going cuckoo.
All right. Thank you so much.
Nice to meet all of you. Thanks for all the good work that you do to help everybody, cats and everybody.
Thank you.
Take care now. Oh, the question of the day. Do you like the question of the day or no?
Yes.
All right. Seems like everybody likes the question of the day.
Yeah.
And I like all of you. I'm Dr. Lori. This is Ask Dr. Lori Live. What fun we had tonight. We'll see you next time.